Could be. Probably going to see a tech startup. Oh, no, we're going to defend R&D. Are we going to see a tech startup? And
I think
remote ice?
Aaron would defend HQ as well.
I don't think he bothered defending HQ against the Shaper.
All right, fine.
Maybe if you see they're on Magnum and they like they're gonna go Vampy.
What? How do you do four actions? Did Hanny also start with only 4 credits at the beginning of the game?
He may have. You know, he's playing on hard mode. And he hasn't realized it. Well, whatever. He's going to face check R&D. See some friends.
Okay. I think that was pretty good for Aaron that turn. And I can draw a card. Draw a card
Get that
card
business.
Again.
Get that business going.
Why? You can just do that for free.
Friends to get advanced and tech startup.
Tech startup
goes in there.
Up, yep.
Advanced. Okay.
There.
This I like. So,
And before start of turn, we're going to raise that.
And he'll just let it sit there to take up Hanny's clicks or to be left there for later abuse.
Yeah, no,
oh, no, he's going
to
do it right now. He's going
to
slap down CVS, hoping that Hanny does not take the time to check it now.
I think if it were up to Hanny, I'd slam the slums and just go. Yeah.
And just go.
Yeah.
This is going to be important. And slums says goodbye. Getting the CVS with the slums would have been big, and it will be big.
It will
hit
be.
It next time.
It will be.
So, tech startup fires. However, this does put Hanny in a behind position. He's at 3 credits. He's not seen a prepaid.
No.
It doesn't look like he has other Ven economy in hand. He's not going to be able to challenge the board state the way he wants to, I don't think.
But I think Hanny just needs to gain a bunch of credits, trash as many things as possible.
But if he doesn't have the means, he's going to have to draw. He's not going to be able to simply click the credits and keep up with...
What's his console again?
Astrolabe?
Yeah, I think he's going to find
running
that.
Free. If he finds
that,
then he's going to be in good shape.
Yeah. That'll help a lot. So, mandatory draw. So, res. Game 3. Oh, draw. Okay.
Yeah. Draw, and install.
I would play the...
He's not seen a single agenda yet, so this is good to just keep leaving HQ open. He's going to install. He's getting rid of the CVS before he can be removed from the game.
Yep.
Very smart. Very smart play.
Well, you can't lose that, right?
No, it's too important.
Just don't want that getting slumped, right?
Yeah. He's wow, really, really defending that that Jeep. So he does not want that extra clip going away.
No, that'll help quite a bit.
Especially with him having the click advantage he does now. And very fortunate having drawn this many cards. I think he's okay with him having that. He's obviously
no,
running a film critic.
Yeah, exactly.
Ah, there, you don't care anymore.
That'd be good if only
Stall, take that credit. Res it. And let's install that.
Yep.
Why not? It's a credit. It's a pain in the ass to check.
So it needs to get a credit for that. Yep. I would install, yep. And then just get a credit. Might as well. Yeah. Oh. Okay.
Did you just draw last click?
Yeah, because he gains 3 off of Jeeves.
What are, oh, right.
Yeah. Runs it.
Sees it again.
Just gain a credit, no?
She's gonna gain the credit and trash that. Okay, you draw for turn.
I can't tell what. Oh, okay.
No, Henny's early asset pressure
draw.
Has really damned him.
Draw
we've got
again?
Our juice. Well, probably if we want the juice click.
Yeah, I think so. Draw again.
And
okay.
Then we.
I play the turtle.
Another turtle box?
Yeah.
I think I like that. And then next turn, install.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's good. Oh. He's just gonna go.
That's good
that
too.
First,
that's
that
really
too.
Good too.
Yeah, Estelle, Turtleback, Tech Startup next turn.
No. Oh, yeah, here we go. That's exactly what Henny needed.
Are we going to see a moon res here?
Yep.
Here we are. Hello, Estelle.
Oh, hi, friend. Yep.
Turtlebacks.
Gain a credit. What?
And then,
how does it get 2? Oh, no. Sorry. The color on her pants looks very similar to the...
So on a tech startup. Gonna compress them, thank you very much, so that we can actually keep an eye on what's going on in the mat.
So you should gain 2 for that. And then.
And then
he's
got
1 card to install.
Okay.
Might as well install the.
Yep. Oh no, we defend that.
Yeah, oh
we
yeah.
defend that.
Oh yeah.
So if he face plants that is huge for him.
Oh yeah.
It'll accelerate the game exponentially. So
look at all these cards that.
So he's got a clock.
Henny has, but
and he can install that.
Can't.
He's gonna have to. So we have to prepay.
Credit.
He doesn't do anything for you here. So.
It's already launched. Oh, this is wild. Game 3 and look at something.
You might go a run. Yeah.
Yeah. Look at
run.
Something. Yeah. Look at that eyes.
HQ.
Eli.
Run on this new one.
That's a good one to hit.
Tech startup.
That's a good one to hit.
The game.
That's a really good one to hit.
It's probably would have wanted to grab a daily business show.
Yes. I think it would have done that as well. Yeah, for sure.
So, if Aaron can actually draw on agenda, now is a good time to biotic.
Yes.
Or is he going to toss the plot? That might be advisable.
Well, he's thinking of what else credit he should do. 5. I think he will be tossing plot, just for the assurance that...
That he'll be able to grab it when he needs it.
Or plot screen.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, because he's 1 credit short of being able to install plot on the fly.
That might be good.
So I think he biotics this out right
yeah.
now.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
Now, do we fire?
No! He's got 10 ice in his deck.
Well, we get a click back with Jeeves and Moon, so we can find Jackson. Or friends.
The odds of it actually doing you any good
are
very poor.
All right.
It will do so, it has so much more potential to go wrong. And so he's going to get the extra click after this, and what is he going to do with it?
Huh?
It says, that is over 50% of the ice in the deck. It is not. It is exactly 50%. He lied. He lied. It is a game of bluffing. It is a game of bluffing, after all.
All right.
And he's going to go ahead and install
another card. Two. Yep. And then get on the counter and move. And you just say go. Yep. So. Yeah, that's really good. Credit, sure gamble?
That or, seems...
Yeah, because you can't run.
Nope. And here it is.
Yep, there you go.
The gamble.
Just gonna do a little, Travis. Just got a little... Alright, that'll help. Yep, can't run. Cannot run.
So how much Blue Moose was it last game? Like 24?
24.
Can you imagine how badly that game would have gone for Eric had he not had those extra 20 credits?
Yes.
Holy crap.
Draw again. Okay. Now he's gonna click back. And then game three.
If at this point, I'm not entirely sure. Like, so.
And he's not running any...
He's got enough money.
Current, so this is going to stick around for quite a bit.
I wonder if he wants to put an agenda where that Jeeves is. He's clearly not got the... He's starting to get some sort of amount of economy. Now he's got a lot of it. but up until now, he wasn't in a great position to be challenging any
yep.
routes. But he seems to be in a much better position. As long as that SMC is there... you're going to have a much harder time of actually... That's not going to do much against the Architect on Moon.
But I think the outermost ice in front of Jeeves, I think it is an Architect.
Which means that Nanaka does a lot of work.
Yes, but the one in Moons will...
One in Moons is great, costing him four.
Draw, okay.
But at least he can break it instead of
yes.
firing.
Yes.
So, what do you do in Aaron's case with an SMC and Sacrificial Construct? He has to believe that the Claude is still in the deck. He doesn't
yep.
know that it's
yep.
in his hand. So he has to think about how he's actually going to score these agendas. I think you have to go for a remote score against the Shaper Hero. And if you wait any longer...
Pop, moves, draw a bunch of cards, see better options.
If you wait any longer, then you aren't going to be able to... you aren't going to be able to challenge them at all because she'll be set up.
Yep.
She'll have a lot of money, and she'll be able to run anywhere. Run to two GFIs.
Five. Now, if it were
running
up to...
Another SL.
So, I think what Aaron probably might want to try to do is spam four things this turn and hide the ability amongst them.
Sure. Maybe he puts two agendas out. I don't think that's a good idea. Mind you. However,
see,
oh, there's an agenda.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
I think this is what's good. Aaron's I mean, it's unfortunate that.
Yeah, the business show.
What do you call it?
And probably Jackson. Oh, it's going to be a GFI in the remote. Because if that remote doesn't get checked, he can biotic quadruple advance
yes.
to be on five. And if he does go check the remote, he might be able to take Vitruvius. Now, it is possible if Hani plays this 100% perfect.
Ooh.
The perfect time to start
that
busting
out.
That
was pretty good.
That was good.
That
was very, very smart. And so now we're getting rid of the SMC, which will take the plot out of play.
I believe
all
plot
we
is
know.
In hand.
Oh, I know. We know this, but I'm
right.
trying to commentate
right.
on it in a way that Aaron believes that the Claude is still
I believe Aaron has only one agenda in hand, so this would be good for him to hit. If he sees it. There
and
you go.
And now he's going to draw into more cards
to
ensure that, or to make this legwork less valuable.
Painful, yeah.
And seeing as we have so many agendas on the table, it's likely that he's going to draw into some non-agendas here.
There's a Vitruvius, three Fairchild.
And a fourth.
And looks like it's in there.
To make him have to film critic it. Why not?
Oh, yeah.
I don't love this because it's indicating that Jackson is not. See, I don't love this at all.
Why not?
So what is he displaying here? Like he's actually no, he'll be able to protect one of the things on the table because he'll have to take it into film critic.
Yep.
And he won't be able to go steal the other one in the same turn. Okay, it's not bad. But the fact that he's indicating non-agenda removals.
I would show the
GFI.
The Vitruvius.
Okay.
Yeah, it's not good, but
it is a line of play. It's not indefensible.
That's exactly right. Yes. Now he's gonna try to find the.
The fact that he res too many is part of the problem as well. He's got one more than he needs. That is a strange little fractured piece of data there. That isn't ideal.
I mean, you could just not see them either. So many cards. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 amongst the other pods. Oh.
Sees GFI.
Oh, he chooses not to film credit. Oh, I guess.
He doesn't need to.
Might as well, yeah. Yeah, slum it. Yeah.
Okay. So, and the other thing I don't like about this play is that it reveals that there are agendas. I mean, he knew that there were agendas. Anyways, if there weren't agendas, then he wouldn't have moved.
But the question is,
and
now,
moving before an agenda score,
like now you've got a 33% chance of guessing where the agenda is. And one of them is out in the open.
A 66% chance of guessing. There are two agendas on the board right now.
Well, he doesn't know that, but he's knowing that there is a Vitruvius somewhere. He knows that for
He displayed it so that it would be harder for him to steal. It would compress his clicks. If he had to take the film critic. Yep. Home critic. And, okay, so he gets the score.
Yep, there it is.
And he takes it on to film critic.
Yep.
Okay, so now he biotics up that.
I wonder if Aaron will remember the black sheet ability. Yep. Yep.
Did he remove that daily business from... There was two removed from games. he actually rested. Never mind. So, this turn, he biotics out that GFI.
Yep.
You have to biotic out the GFI. You have to.
Yep.
If you install Remont and you don't res that card, it indicates that it's not installed. So what is it? Why would you defend it?
But I think Aaron might be considering defending it, which is a weird point. I mean, you've got enough money.
You've got enough money that you could defend it. You could arguably defend it and then advance.
I wouldn't. It's just if I put more stuff in there, then now whatever that card's called gets stronger. Not good. Can't get these new cards, man.
Yeah, he's gonna do it.
Yep.
This is the right play.
Yep. Advance.
5 times.
Gain a flick back. advance. Yep.
DBS is in play, Aaron. It is not a thing.
Yeah, that's very weird.
Okay. Anyhow, so he's going to draw some cards, and he's going to just make some money. He's got all three prepaids now, so we're going to see a deuce is wild.
Game three.
For sure.
Check that out.
Yeah. See what's defending R&D. It's just another Eli.
Run it. It only costs you four.
Okay. I got loads of money right now. He's going to make a run. He's actually going to trash it. He's going to run from the game. It's a pain in the neck. And he's going to install the clot to
there you go.
To force.
You know, this is good. You're right. I don't think Henny has any more economy in his hand. So what he should do is install a bunch of ice in front of the G's.
Yeah.
And then replace the G's after it's done to gain the agenda to win the game.
I like that. Because he doesn't have enough money to install a code gate breaker.
Yeah. I like this a lot. Because, like, he
would have to run first click to get through a fair chop.
Yes, but he's going to put another one there.
No, but it wouldn't even make because he doesn't have enough money to then break the Eli that's behind it.
Yes, that's right. That's
so
right.
A Fairchild Eli server is perfect here.
Yeah, it's good piloting by Aaron here. So he puts that away. Yeah, biotic. Biotic? It's less things for Hammond to trash, right?
Sure. Well, Hammond's not in a position to be trashing things right now.
No, but I mean, like, you just don't want him to gain access to things to trash. Sure. And you want to keep... Oh, I'm so fucking... Okay.
To
the bottom.
Oh, I thought he might want some troops, unless he's already holding onto an agenda.
He is.
No. Oh, okay. Are you sure?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, yeah, I do see a Vitruvius. My bad.
Yep.
Is he in three altered Vitruviuses or full art Vitruviuses? That's commitment. That's three purchases. And. Did he just install the Vitruvius out there?
Yes,
he's
going to
try and cheat out the game? That's interesting. I mean, it is expensive for an Anatka to deal with.
No. So what he's going to do is he's going to put
defend
the...
Defend it?
Yeah.
Yeah,
exactly.
That's the way
exactly.
You play it.
And then...
Because
geez.
He won't be able to break both of them.
Yep.
Oh, this is... this is game.
I like this a lot.
Yeah, this is the right play.
I like this a lot. 18 credits. That's pretty good.
I don't see... any play that Hanny can make here that would be the only play I can see is a stim hack.
I don't think he has that in his deck.
No, he doesn't, but that it would be good.
Yes.
It'd be
sure.
Good right now.
Yeah. I saw also the problem with this was he didn't see any of his lucky cards.
Yeah. He spent too much time challenging
But that's what
assets.
You're supposed to do.
Not without an economy.
Well,
he
I mean,
have,
like...
He didn't have anything set up. If you... That is what asset spam...
Wants you to do.
It wants you to break yourself so that in the early game so that you cannot build up a board state that will be able to challenge a later game.
For sure.
Because although the ice are perfectly known in moons, if you don't actually have a way to address these very powerful, very affordable ice, they will walk all over you.
Yep.
Because he challenged a few key things, but what did he actually remove from the game? What was actually impactful?
1, 2, 3. Oh, so you drew into Lucky Five.
Okay.
but now he can't run.
He can. He's because he's got 5 clicks because of Beth.
Whoa, but I mean, he wants to install the Gordian and run.
He's got a clone chip SMC with Burke. Are you just gonna check that? It's over.
That's it.
That's it.
Oh, good on Aaron.
He's going for it.
And draw. And he's gonna go through the motions.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Even gonna choose a card, one that he likes, and triple advance for the game.
Yep.
All right. And we have ourselves a court split with plenty of time to spare.
Yeah.